exciting night for me for two reasons. The first is that my new CD is out and available for sale, and it took a little over 2 years to make a lot of work, so I'm really excited about that. And the second reason is, as many of you know, most of you are friends, I have been struggling with chronic pain in both of my arms for years and years and years, and it inhibits a lot of what I'm able to do. But tonight, after over 2 years of working with my wonderful and diligent acupuncturist who has yet to give up on me, this is the first time in over a decade that I'm able to perform without arm braces, which may not seem like a really big deal, but is a really big deal to me. So to celebrate, I got to wear, oh, thank you. So to celebrate, I wore the most fun, sparkly dress I could find that shows off no arm braces. Welcome, come in, there's seats in the front. Come. So the program tonight, as you can see on your program, is Marimba Journey, and the music is from all over the world. And we're gonna start with a piece based on African music. This piece is called Ganaya, and it was written by the German composer Matthias Schmidt. And Schmidt wrote this after a trip he took to the African country of Ghana, where he experienced a really profound connection with the music there. So he wrote Ganaya for the marimba because the instrument has its roots in Africa. Actually, the word marimba comes from the Bantu language, meaning wood that sings. And also because the marimba enabled him to connect his European musical experiences with his newfound African insight. So he wrote this piece as an homage to the rhythms of Ghana and the wisdom of the people who have passed their music on to new generations for centuries. So, Ganaya.
Thank you.
beeping is continuously beeping on both sides of the audience. So just a check-in, make sure all electronic devices are off if possible. But now we are going to travel up into the far north with a piece called Northern Lights. And this was written by the composer Eric Awaizen, who is a composer and professor at Juilliard, and he's better known for his brass compositions, mostly low brass, but he's written one of the most beautiful pieces for the marimba, in my opinion. And this piece has many, many sections, and they are all greatly varied, very, very different, definitely not melody and accompaniment. There are slower passages that focus on dynamic changes from loud to soft and lots of subtle changes in between, and there's very fast passages, and there's everything in between. And all of these differences in volume, texture, mood, tempo, they're all meant to evoke the shimmering, curtain-like beauty of the Northern Lights. So I invite you to sit back. You can close your eyes if you'd like. It doesn't offend me. And picture being outside at night somewhere where you can see the Northern Lights, and you're watching them dance and change and shift and not everything in the sky and how beautiful they are, and then imagine how that is transcribed into music in this piece. So, Northern Lights.
Thank you.
to move back down into this country with the traditional American folk song of Shenandoah. And this is a song that's on my new album, Lullabies. And I arranged the sort of more common four-verse version. So you will hear the melody four times, but each time the texture is a little bit different, thick, thin, and the melody moves around on the instrument. So it's not just the same thing four times in a row. Although it's so beautiful, I don't know that that would really
matter.
natural environment in Japan. And this is a quote from her about writing this piece. In the early morning haze, as I stood in the middle of a bamboo grove, I became enwrapped in a rich medley of sound. Listening to the bamboo leaves rustling against each other and the occasional whip of the breeze, I seemed to hear the song of the wind. I sensed the dynamic and powerful nature of life forces. I took out of my pocket a marble and threw it into the grove. The blue marble disappeared into the morning haze, leaving behind it beautiful echoes as it rebounded from stalk to stalk. So that's what she was thinking about when she wrote this. I like to add to that some of the elements of my own little bamboo grove, such as the enormous flocks of birds that come every evening and are beautiful and make lots of noise, and various cats who like to explore the very dense maze of the bamboo, and dogs who may be chasing after the cats, and all of these elements, as well as the different sounds that the wind makes in the bamboo. So I hope you are able to hear some of those elements as you enjoy the piece.
Thank you.
And he said that the fluid nature of this piece, along with its long arcing lines, remind him of the beautiful cliffs of Ireland. And if you're not familiar with the Cliffs of Moher, which I wasn't, they've made an appearance in some movies. I think the latest movie is Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, but I'm not familiar with that one, so I don't know where the cliffs are. The one I know, and I hope all of you know, is The Princess Bride. When Andre the Giant is carrying everybody up the cliffs at the beginning with everybody on his back, those are the cliffs. So, and when I'm playing, I like to think about the various natural events that you would witness if you were at the cliffs, like looking out over the ocean, and maybe it's calm and becomes agitated, and there's waves crashing against cliffs. Maybe you're watching birds floating on thermals, or butterflies and insects, you know, buzzing around your face, all those things. And you can hear these different events as the different sections of the piece. And they're all connected through intervallic structure and the fluidity and contour you hear established right at the beginning of the piece, just as all of these different natural events are connected by being at the same place in the same time. So, Cliffs of Moher. Thank you. We're going down to South America. This is by the Brazilian composer Ney Rosário, and this is the solo version of his concerto for marimba and orchestra. But my orchestra couldn't make it tonight, so it's just me. And so this is just the marimba concerto suite. And an interesting fact about this piece, it's the most popular concerto ever written. It's been played more times than any other concerto, which I know is really hard to believe, but happens to be true. And you can hear the various Brazilian rhythms and melodies in this piece that has a real South American flavor, and it's really fun to play and hopefully really fun to listen to. So again, thank you all, and hopefully I will speak with you after.
Thank you. Thank you.